Hello, aviation professionals, people who do fly, maintain, and inspect civil aircraft. Welcome again to my aviation training solution for today. Your host is Haysam Ali from Cairo, Egypt, and I am an aviation technical instructor. Today, we are going to go through aircraft computers, and I'm going to pinpoint a very important philosophy or issue. First, I need to tell you that most aircraft systems nowadays are computerized. So we are having like even double or triple computers for system functions. For example, flight control computers, landing gears, flight controls, fuel system, and even hydraulic systems are computerized nowadays. So for example, for the fuel system, we are having like fuel control and the monitoring computer 1 and 2. For the landing gear, we are having LGCIU 1 and 2 for control, indication, and monitoring. So, during operations, we may suffer from a computer fault, and we need to take action before flight regarding this computer. So, probably we are going through the minimum equipment list and see what the manufacturer tells us to do, if it is a go or no-go item, if we need to make like a swapping between computers, or if we need to replace this aircraft computer. So we need to take an action and know about the dispatch rule of this computer. So, generally speaking, I need to tell you that the computer which are having a role in control, it will be a no-go item. Again, the computer which having a role in a control function or a computer which give orders, probably it will be a no-go item. On the other side, the computer which is only for indication and monitoring, the computer which is only for indication and monitoring, it will be a go item. This is the difference. This is generally speaking. So for example, for the flight control or for the fuel system, maybe you are having FCMC 1 and FCMC 2, fuel control and the monitoring computer 1 and fuel control and the monitoring computer 2. When you are studying or when you are going through the system, you will find that FCMC 1 are there for most of the control functions. But FCMC 2 are generally taking a role in indication and the monitoring. So when you go through the MEL, probably you will find that FCMC 1 is a no-go item. But on the other side, FCMC 2 will be a go item. This is the point I need to tell you about from my experience, from my little experience. So again, you need to consult your aircraft maintenance manual. This is for training purposes only. It shall not supersede any official document like aircraft maintenance manual, flight crew operating manual, and MEL. Thank you for your good listening, and always fly safely and maintain your aircraft very safely. See you and bye-bye.